على أن في رواية مسلم من طريق العلاء بن عبد الرحمن عن أبيه عن أبي هريرة ما يدل على إرادة عدم الحصر، فإن لفظه من علامة المنافق ثلاث. No. What's the explanation given by Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani? He said, here, لأنه لا يلزم من عد الخصلة المذمومة الدالة. It is not compulsory for the number of these disparaging or bad features of munafiq. The number is not important here. The number is not important to prove the sign of a hypocrite. But whenever the number is more, the hypocrisy is more. The nifaq is more. Only that much. This أن تكون العلامات الدالة على أصل النفاق والخصلة الزائدة إذا أضيفت إلى ذلك. Whenever additional feature of a hypocrite is added to his characteristic feature, to his behavior, then كمل بها خلوص النفاق. His نفاق will be perfect. Only that much. So, the more the number of features of a munafiq, then the more will be his hypocrisy, the more will be his nifaq, perfectness of his nifaq. Okay, only that much. But the number is not important regarding hypocrisy, but regarding the perfectness of or the depth of hypocrisy, the number is important. Only that much. Okay. Because أن في رواية مسلم من طريق العلاء بن عبد الرحمن نبيه أن أبي هريرة one hadith reported by أبو هريرة and recorded by Imam Muslim there it is من علامة المنافق ثلاث. Among the signs of a hypocrite there are three features. So the three number three is not limited. Okay, among the signs means among the signs or out of the signs of a munafiq, there are three features. Means there are not three only, not limited to three. There are other features too. And among those features of a hypocrite, there are three. Means there are other features too, not limited to three alone, but three important features mentioned here, only that much. In another hadith, four important features mentioned. Then you see not only these three or four features, other features are also there, but three or four main features or important features are mentioned in these two hadiths. Okay, follow. Now the next module we see, module 3. قال القرطبي أيضا والنبوي حصل من مجموع الروايتين خمس خصال لأنهما تواردتا على الكذب في الحديث والخيانة في الأمانة وزاد الأول الخلف في الوعد والثاني الغدر في المعاهدة والفجور في الخصومة. قلت نو إمام قرطبي أن إمام نووي also إمام قرطبي أن إمام نووي reports they say both of them say حصل من مجموع الروايتين خمس خصال. When we assemble, when we combine these two hadith, we get five features of a munafiq. They say لأنهما تواردتا على الكذب في الحديث والخيانة في الأمانة. And in two hadith we see in common two features of a hypocrite, which are they? الكذب في الحديث. This telling lies when in speeches. Telling lies when one speaks. So that is one feature common in both the hadith. Okay. Then والخيانة في الأمانة. And that is proving to be cheating or treacherous in the case of amanat. In the case of amanat, trusts. Okay. So these two features are common in both the hadith, commonly mentioned. Okay. وَزَادَ الْأَوَّلُ الْخُلْفَ فِي الْوَعْدِ. And in the first hadith, additional feature is that khulfu fil wa'd, that is breaking in the case of promises, breaking the promises. So that is in the first hadith, additional feature. وَالثَّانِي الْغَدْرَ فِي الْمُعَاهَدَةِ وَالْفُجُورَ فِي الْخُصُومَةِ. And in the second hadith, two additional features are mentioned, that is الْغَدْرُ فِي الْمُعَاهَدَةِ, that is proving to be treacherous in the case of treaties, in the case of covenants, مُعَاهَدَة, وَالْفُجُورَ, and behaving an, in an insulting or abusing manner, that is in the case of quarreling, khusuma, that is whenever he used to quarrel, he will be using insulting words. So mu'min, a believer, should not be quarreling, a quarreling person, a quarrelsome person. Mu'min or believers should not quarrel each other, but whenever it happens, or if by chance or accidentally if it occurs, then if he's a munafiq, a munafiq's feature will be that he will be using insulting or abusing words when he quarrels, okay, then with other person. كأن بعض الرواة تصرف في لفظه لأن معناهما قد يتحد. So here غدر في المعاهدة, an أمانة إن خيانة, or وعد في الخلف, all are similar in meaning. Okay, similar word in meaning. So they can be treated as one feature. That is وعد في الخلف في الوعد and غدر في المعاهدة, both can be treated as one. But some persons, some scholars treated as treated them as two. Okay, just like Imam Nawawi and Imam Qurtubi. But Imam Ibn Hajar say these two features can be combined, or these two features can be treated as one. Then وعلى هذا, upon this فالمزيد خصلة واحدة, then additional feature is only one. That is فهي الفجور والخصومة, that is quarreling. When one quarrels, he used to use fujur or abusing or insulting words. Okay, so that's enough for the day. Tomorrow we shall continue, Sunday we shall continue the later portion, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.